Welcome back to Indy Style, everybody. She's the dietitian that you've never had, always wanted. Michelle Dudash is in the house, in our kitchen, whipping up some guac. What is it?
It's Italian style guacamole.
Ooh, you know what? I don't think I've ever heard of that.
I haven't either.
Nope. I mean, if I hadn't heard of it,
Well, it's my latest creation, Anessa.
And she's put herself in a cookbook, and we can get that. Pre-order it now, right?
Yes, pre-order now. Actually, I'll send you some free bonus materials too if you send me the receipt. I'll post it on my Instagram today.
Yeah,
so
follow
check that
her on Instagram. She's always posting delicious recipes, events she does. So how do you make Italian style guac?
Yeah, so of course we start with our good old fashioned ripe avocados. And I like to mash them with two spoons.
Oh.
This is a trick I learned from one of my best friends, Kristen. Uh-huh. And I really like it. It's my new method because it doesn't get too mushed.
Right.
It's like chunky and creamy.
And well, that's such a good point.
Yeah.
Because a lot of times I use a fork and it's just, this is a, such an, I'm enjoying watching you do this.
Thank you.
So does it save you time doing two spoons like that?
Or it does, two spoons. Maybe you could even put a third in there.
It's like the perfect texture.
Yeah, so now it's perfect. You saw how easy that was. And then, of course, we're still adding some tomatoes, like I would normally in my guacamole. But this is what we're doing that gives it a little twist. We're adding in, so I have some chili flakes, some garlic powder, and pepper. But the balsamic vinegar is what is a little different in this. So I'm gonna put a tablespoon in this. So usually you'd put lime in there for your Mexican guacamole. I use balsamic, and then we have some basil leaves. So I'll just tear up some basil. This is fresh from my husband's garden. Love him for doing that.
Aww.
And then I'm adding in some toasted pine nuts.
Oh, this is
gives
different.
It a little crunch.
Yeah.
And then still some red onion. But that addition of the balsamic and the basil really gives it a nice twist. It's completely different.
I bet this goes so well together.
Yeah,
it's all of those great Italian flavors, but with the fresh avocado.
Yes, yes. Yum. So all pantry ingredients. So this is delicious. Now, what you can serve this with is some red pepper planks, or I'll do some like almond flour crackers or seeded crackers, and you just dip those in there and you have a wonderful low-carb snack. Of course, if you want to do some bread toast, you can put this on toast for breakfast too. So
red
just
pepper
dip
plates.
Right into
I like
that.
Them.
Yummy. So yum. So yum.
Okay, I'm going to try some of that. Can I? Is that okay?
Well, of course.
And
yes,
of course, you're going to go on
just hand,
to the
I'll just hand you the whole bowl. There you go.
Yeah. Pass it down.
Okay, so the next recipe I'll get mixing. Will you guys give that a taste?
Okay.
If I have a quinoa salad. So this is a Mediterranean quinoa salad. Yeah, just dig right in. I hope the salt is perfect for you there. Well, here's actually
it's
the rest
gonna
of
be
the
amazing.
Salt. Maybe sprinkle those in there too.
Okay. So a quinoa salad, right?
Yeah, quinoa salad. Thank you, Randy. Thank you. So we have a quinoa salad here.
Sure.
I'm adding some. Now the quinoa, I just cooked in vegetable broth instead of water. That gives it a lot more flavor. We have some scallions. And quinoa, of course, we're getting all that fiber and protein.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I could eat this as a lunch, even a light dinner. I mean, this has all the protein, the veggies. Here's some diced cucumber. You see how these Mediterranean flavors, that you can use them over and over again into completely new dishes.
Well, that's the thing. That's what I love about what you do, is it's not like we're buying a whole nother basket full of different things. You're taking similar ones and using them in a different way.
Exactly. Here's some fresh lemon. And this is making our vinaigrette, so I'll put a whole lemon in here, squeeze that in. I added some red onion, I also added some Kalamata olives. My new favorite thing is pre-sliced Kalamata olives that come in the jar. I used to buy the whole.
Oh, brother.
I just decided to start taking shortcuts.
Uh-huh.
So I encourage you to get those. And then I'm gonna finish this up with some more avocado. And then I have some mint as well. Fresh chopped mint, of course, parsley, basil, really whatever you have, chive, and here's our avocado. So we just toss that together and you have this gorgeous Mediterranean quinoa salad.
That looks pretty.
Well, it's so beautiful. Yeah. I can think like what's coming up this weekend, Memorial Day or some of the summer picnic. Picnic King is my favorite.
Picnic King.
Do you love to make Mediterranean food, Michelle? Is that like one of your go-tos?
I'm going to pass this down. Yes, please. I like this. I like the style. It's family style TV.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's right. That's a really good point. Okay, Alice, here you go. Quinoa.
Just expanding
your palate here on Indy Style.
Expand my
good
palate.
Good stuff. You go ahead and dive in. Okay. All right, Michelle, where can we get more from you? Remind us.
Yes, go to my website, MichelleDudash.com.
Oh, she's making one more thing. Okay, go ahead at it, my friend. We will include it. You can pass it down to me and Amber, and that way we can show it
to the show. Okay, perfect. Awesome. This is a burrata platter. Easy to whip up.
All right.